done. Are you injured, ma'am?
Here you go, Ada. One slightly dented, but still functional radar beacon.
This will do nicely. And, with any luck, it'll help us trace the mechanist's signal.
Don't worry. I'm sure it'll do the trick.
I certainly hope so. I'm going to begin my decryption routine, but it could take a while. In the meantime, I've picked up another RoboBrain beacon signal. It should be the last one you'll need to collect.
Good work, Ada.
Thank you. If my calculations are correct, the signal is coming from... Oh, this isn't good. Location confirmed. The RoboBrain is at Fort Hagen Satellite Array, which means it's in the hands of the Rust Devils.
Who or what are the Rust Devils?
Allow me to explain. My old caravan encountered them once while crossing the river into the city. The Rust Devils are a group of ruthless raiders who utilize robots for their nefarious practices. They scour the Commonwealth looking for my kind. What they can't capture and reprogram, they strip for spare parts. I realize they pose a greater threat to me than you. I just want you to be well informed. That being said, despite what lies ahead, I can easily continue to decrypt the signal as we proceed. So shall we be on our way?
Nothing there now. What do you think?
Oh. Hey!
No more hiding for you. Well done, man. Any idea where they went?
Make it quick.
Heads up.
Easy!
My apologies. I think... Visual system damaged. I've lost them, ma'am.
Disappearing act, huh? Come on out. I'll make it nice and quick. You can trust me.
Careful, ma'am. I don't hear. Over here.
What happened?
Continuing. Four. Hostile has escaped. Transmitting. Description to designated law enforcement authorities. Order will be restored. Please stand by.
You don't look like one of the Rust Devils. What are you doing here?
Do not interfere with security operations.
Gotta be joking.
Sometime, asshole.
Call on the Commonwealth. It is I, the Mechanist. I got...
You don't look like one of the Rust Devils. What are you doing here?
When you turn up, you're dead. You don't look like one of the Rust Devils. What are you doing here?
Hunting down a radar beacon.
A radar beacon? How very interesting. That's a very specific part to be searching for. And you don't look like the typical part scavenger type to me. I calculate a 98.8% chance that you're looking for the Mechanist. If I'm correct, and I usually am, then perhaps we can help each other with our respective predicaments.
I could definitely use the help.
I thought you might say something like that. Now, how can I put this as simple as possible so someone at your processing speed can understand? In order to find the Mechanist, you're going to need more than just my radar beacon. You're going to need access to the facility. I'm willing to provide said access, but you'll have to fulfill two simple conditions. One, you need to get me as far away as you can from these lunatics. And two, find me a new body. Once both conditions are satisfied, I'll gladly provide you with everything you need. Do we have a deal?
Deal.
A wise decision. Once we're at our destination, I'll happily relinquish my radar beacon as a gesture of good faith. Now, I strongly suggest you stop loitering in the middle of a hostile location and get us both out of here at once.
Alive. The Mechanist. I come to warn you of a new scourge who stalks the innocent and destroys my robot allies.
tripwires. I'd rather keep myself intact today, thank you.
What the hell was that?
Unidentified intruder detected.
Sensor alert.
Beginning search.
Anomaly detected. Assaultron class combat robot.
You really are taking the path of most resistance here, aren't you?
All clear. Intruder, identify yourself.
Hell yeah!
Found the target again. Find anything useful?
No stats! Assault not engaged!
Mistake, rookie!
I got all day!
takes care of that.
I'm in.
Based on my limited experience with you, I estimate a 65% chance of making it out of here. Not optimal. An increase in effort could have an impact on the odds.
Shit's got ambushed. Getting shook up over nothing.
This is the one that ripped my head off. I demand we rip her head off. It's only fair.
Soltron class combat robot to unknown interloper.
My apologies. I've lost sight of my target. Visual system damaged.
Had I a body, I would have killed her myself. Oh well. Six of one, half dozen of the other. Good job, human. refuse to cooperate until you provide a body that meets my standards.
Here you go, Ada. The final radar beacon. I'll need that head back when you're done.
Of course. Shouldn't take but a moment. There you go. Still in one piece. I'm not sure why you want the head back. All we needed was its radar beacon. Besides, robo-brains are notorious for being, well, a real pain in the neck.
What else do you know about the Meta?
Quite simply, it's the first time General Atomics produced a successful union between organic matter and robotics. The brain is used both as a control unit and a data storage unit, which is far more efficient than using standard circuits. Unfortunately, there were a lot of programming issues with these robots which caused them to be a bit, shall we say, unhinged. Hopefully, this particular robo-brain will have some of the answers that we've been seeking.
A union of organic matter and robotics? Sounds an awful lot like a synth.
Not at all. The robo-brain was built with a very different design philosophy in mind. General Atomics' intent was to use the human brain to augment the robot's functions. Primarily, to accelerate the decision-making process. Free thought and individuality was never intended. These were expressly built like soldiers, to follow orders without question. The robo-brain's unfortunate tendency towards violence and aggression should be considered more of a malfunction than a calculated decision.
Now that you have the final radar beacon, will it be enough to track down the mechanist's location?
I certainly hope so. I've already started the calculations while we've been having this conversation. That still doesn't explain why you need that head back.
We still need it, Ada. I believe it can help us access the mechanist's facility.
Of course. It makes perfect sense that the mechanist would not only keep its location a closely guarded secret, but would secure it against intrusion as well. I'm terribly sorry. I hadn't considered that possibility at all. I'm afraid when it comes to assisting humans, I'm not doing very well lately.
Why would you say something like that?
Isn't it obvious? Ever since I let my friends die in that caravan, I feel like I've been failing in my duties. I chose the route we took the day we were attacked. Perhaps if I'd selected an alternate route, they'd still be alive. Sometimes I wish that Jackson had programmed me with my personality mode set permanently to disabled.
Your personality mode? What do you mean?
Most robots have a personality mode select available to them for their creator to utilize. Turn it on, and we're designed to talk and act more like a human. Turn it off, and we're no better than a mindless automaton. Jackson said he didn't think of me as a servitor robot. He treated me more like a friend. So he permanently set my personality mode to on. He said I should never lose my identity. I suppose I'm starting to think he was wrong.
Your personality defines you as an individual. Never let that go.
You're right. All of the good memories I've experienced being Ada would be lost if my personality mode was shut down. I can't afford to lose them. I really think I needed to hear that from someone else. Thank you. Now I've distracted you for long enough. I'll finish up my calculations while you deal with our new friend, Jezebel. Hopefully, she'll be able to grant us access to the Mechanist's facility and we can put an end to this nonsense once and for all.
Interesting. This body you've selected for me isn't quite what I had envisioned, but it will have to suffice.
I'm sorry you feel that way. It's the best I could do.
Yes. Well, it's certainly better than being stuck to a machine surrounded by rust devils poking and prodding me for their amusement. Look, it's obvious we don't care for each other's company, which suits me just fine. So, why don't you ask me everything you wanted to know, and then I'll be on my way.
Tell me everything you know about the Mechanist.
Now there's a fascinating subject. The Mechanist, amazingly adept at programming, a veritable genius with electronics. I'm not surprised you're interested. I've been dutifully carrying out the Mechanist's instructions, to help the people of the Commonwealth for quite a long time.
Helping the people of the Commonwealth? You?
Absolutely. It's my primary directive. The Mechanist instructed me to seek out and help the people of the Commonwealth. By my calculations, the easiest way to help a human is simply to destroy it. There's no point in prolonging a laughably fragile life. It's the most efficient way to assist them. Any other effort to help tends to result in numerous complex side effects.
The Mechanist gave you these instructions to kill people?
Well, not exactly. The specific instruction was to help people. I merely interpreted the most efficient way to perform my duties. Assisting a human to the best of my abilities only affords a 25% survival rate. That means there's a 75% chance that despite my efforts, the human I'm assisting will die from something beyond my control. Therefore, it's better to hasten the human's death and put them out of their likely chance of misery than to deplete my limited time. It's actually quite elementary, but given your minimal intellect, I suppose I shouldn't be surprised you don't understand.
Can we stop with the petty bickering and just get to the part where you tell me how to access the Mechanist facility?
I promised to answer your questions, and unlike humans, I don't have the capacity to lie. It's rather simple, really. In order to gain entry to the Mechanist facility, you're going to need to outfit one of your robots with an MSAT modification. I'll upload the plans to your Pip-Boy device. There. I've fulfilled my portion of our agreement. Perhaps I'll remain here for a while and see how things resolve between yourself and the Mechanist. Purely for my own amusement, of course. I suspect you'll have quite a tale to tell once you return. But then again, I'd be surprised if you ever return at all. I expect you'll be leaving me behind. Typical. Just go away. Haven't you done enough to torment me already? Haven't you already interfered enough? Go away. At least now I'll have time to work on my pi to the last digit calculation. Haven't you already interfered enough? Go away. At least now I'll have time to work on my pi to the last digit calculation.
I hope you have additional fusion cores to spare.
Hey.
How may I trust you've completed your business with Jezebel. I hope she wasn't too difficult.
Is there a chance these robots could be misinterpreting orders?
Yes, I've considered the possibility. The contradictory nature of the Mechanist's broadcasts are troubling. But the truth is, regardless of intent, the Mechanist needs to be stopped. These robots are too much a threat. Were you able to discover how to gain access to the Mechanist?
I need to outfit a robot with something called an MSAT. Jezebel gave me the plans.
A custom modification that acts as a key to the Mechanist facility. Very smart. In fact, chances are high the MSAT may be required for multiple access points, like a robot identification card. As for my task, I was able to decrypt the signal with the final radar beacon. The source is coming from a Robco sales and service center, most likely a front for a larger operation. It's time to take the offensive. Have you formulated a plan?
Did you have any ideas?
I am at an impasse. I wish to see the Mechanist endure the same fate as my friends, but I know this to be due to my personality subroutine. When I compartmentalize, I want to know reason and motive before passing judgment. This is why I leave the decision to you. Now, if you're ready, I believe you have an MSAT to install.
This unit is currently in factory default mode. Do you wish to enable this unit's personality subroutine?
Personality subroutine? Would you mind explaining that to me?
Processing. This unit is equipped with a dynamic personality subroutine to allow a more human-like interface. This subroutine is equipped with several advanced AI protocols such as emotion, humor, companionship, and empathy. The personality subroutine is highly recommended by the manufacturer. If long-term rapport with this unit is expected, do you wish to enable this unit's personality subroutine?
Sure, that would be great.
Acknowledged. Personality subroutine activated. A pleasure to see you again, ma'am. Are you ready to depart?
All systems go?
Don't worry. I may look unique, but all of my systems are operating properly. So, shall we depart?
Time to hit the road.
Understood. Please, lead on.